and telling a story. After 36 years of being in the government, what can a man who is double your age tell you today? Must be the curiosity in your minds. I have been in the police for the last 33 years. From the age of 20, I have been working 14 to 16 hours a day. It has been the most thrilling experience. So I am going to speak to you something from my own experience and how it has taught me the philosophy of life. It is a time-tested philosophy, but no doubt I thought I would share it with a small film. This happened to me 24 years back, 20 years back, while in the thick of Veerappan operations, I had a bullet on my neck. And most of you know who Veerappan was. I think at least the younger generation may not be much aware. He was the most dreaded outlaw, the biggest manhunt ever in post-independent India was against him. His reign of terror extended to 6,000 square kilometers of the tropical forest in the Western Ghats. He had killed 184 people, poached more than 200 elephants for the tuskers. He had taken to crime at the age of 14. And he had looted the forest produce worth $13 million. The government had a price of $1 million on his head. He had kidnapped a large number of celebrities. And Dr. Rajkumar was one. And I think most of people in Karnataka and in the southern part of India are probably aware of that. Rajkumar had to spend 108 days in captivity. He kidnapped a minister and killed him. And his ferocity was so much that people dreaded to take part in the Veerappan operations. At the young age of 39, I decided I'll volunteer for this. It is a crisis which I have to take up. Many people advised me, why do you want to volunteer and take part in this? And my answer to them was, traveling on the national highways today is much more dangerous than taking part in an operation of this kind. It's the minimum that I can do to my own department and to the society around. Let me tell you the travails after that incident. The bullet that hit my neck cut my trachea and esophagus. No medical aid was available anywhere close by. The nearest medical center was about an hour away. I was just 39, married for 6 years, had a son of 4 years, and a younger son of 3.5 months. I was rushed to the hospital. I had to undergo an emergency tracheostomy. Doctors did not believe that I would ever survive. The bullet that hit my neck got lodged in the lungs. The bullet could not be removed from my lungs for more than 24 hours. They had to fly in a doctor from Chennai with special tools to extract that bullet from my lung. In the process of extraction of that bullet, they damaged my vocal cord. Today, when I speak to you, I'm just speaking on one vocal cord. 5 months into the hospital, 5 major surgeries. Each surgery lasting from 6 to 8 hours. But I survived. I survived the crisis. I came out and I began to walk. I began to walk. I'd lost 45 kilos of weight. I was just weighing around 40 kilograms. When I was shorted, I was probably of the size that I am now. But nevertheless, why I narrate you this incident is that there is a crisis. Each one of us is going to go through a crisis. This crisis, when it comes, how it comes, no one knows. How prepared are we? Are we prepared? If we are prepared, how do we face the crisis of life? As youngsters here, I'm sure each one of you will face a crisis at some point of time or the other. But the challenge lies in how do you face it and how do you overcome it. There is a lot of beauty in facing challenges, in facing the test of times. It is only your ability to get on. And I'm sure each one of us has that strength in him. Because when I was shorted, I did not know whether I'm going to live or not. But I decided that come what may, I'll put in the best of my efforts to survive. 60 inches of my body was stitched. I did stitch. But still, after 20 years, the enthusiasm for life has only kept on increasing. I have been able to play tennis. I have been able to swim. I have been able to ride horses. And I have been able to hold a large number of sensitive appointments. I'm telling you the story of my personal life because every one of us will be having this situation. It may not be a life-threatening situation like the one that I have gone through. But in day-to-day life, in everyday life, you are bound to have one or the other incident which is going to challenge you. And it's only at that point of time that you will have to bring out all your resources. And the message that I would like to convey today is that you need to live life. You need to live every day of your life. Every day is an important day. Ensure that you give the fullest of your efforts, fullest of your capabilities to every day. Don't think of something very far away, but today, every day, you need to live your life. Thank you very much.